आळ्वारेम्पेरुमानार् जीयर् तिरुवडिगळे शरणम् जीयर् तिरुवडिगळे शरणम् श्री भगवद्गीता 17th चाप्टर् वि आर् कमिङ्ग् टुवर्ड्स् दि एण्ड् आफ् दि 17th चाप्टर् इन् दि 17th चाप्टर् त्री टैप्स् आफ् श्रद्धा फेत् आर् एक्स्प्लैन्ड् बै भगवान् चाप्टर् इस् टैटल्ड् श्रद्धात्रय विभागयोगम् नाट् ओन्ली दि फेत् बट् दि औट्कम् आफ् सच् फेत् which is in the form of dhanam, tapasya, yajnam and so on. They are also classified in this manner into sattvika, rajasa and tamasa ways. And Bhagavan has explained all of those in this particular chapter. We have seen up to that, up to 25 shlokams now. In the first 22 shlokams, Bhagavan explained the categorizations of all of these, and from 23rd shlokam he started explaining that all of these are Vaidika karmas. They are all performed as part of Vaidika rituals, and when such activities, when such rituals are performed, they should be accompanied by Om Tat Sat. These three words must be recited, and then only the particular activity must be done. That was explained in 23rd shlokam. In 24th and 25th shlokam, Bhagavan explained about Om and Tat, the essence of those and the purpose of those. Now from 26th shlokam, he is going to explain about the word Sat, and then finally the concluding shlokam in 28th shlokam. So let us see that today. Bhagavad Ramanuja has given Gita Bhashyam, which is an elaborate Sanskrita Vyakhyanam for Bhagavad Gita. Vedanta Charya has given Tatparya Chandrika, which is another Sanskrita commentary for Bhagavad Gita. Puttur Sri Uve Krishna Swami Iyengar has given elaborate Tamil commentary based on these existing commentaries. As part of that, he has given word by word meanings, which we have translated into English and have placed it in our website. With the help of this English translation, we are going through simple meanings for Bhagavad Gita. Let us see 26th shlokam. Sadbhave sadubhave cha saditi yetat prayujyate prashaste karmani tata satchabdaha partha yujyate. So in this shlokam, Bhagavan is explaining the meanings for the word Sat. There are different meanings. We are going to see them here. Partha, O son of Kunti. Kunti's another name is Pritha. Being son of Pritha, Arjuna is known as Partha. So Bhagavan is calling him as Partha. Sat iti etat. The word Sat. Sadbhave, indicating an entity which exists. Generally, Sat means that which exists. That is a general meaning for Sat. It is seen in Shastram also in many places. Sat means eternal presence. Whether it is Achit or Chit or Ishvara. All these three entities, they are Sat only because all of those exist all the time. So Sat generally means that which exists in that particular concept. And then Sadbhave, that indicates the entity which exists. And then Sadubhave cha. Sadubhave means, Sadhu means good. Generally in Sanskritam we hear Sadhu, Sadhu, that means very good. So Sadubhave cha, which means indicating that it is a good entity. So when it's said as Sadubhave, that means the particular entity is a good entity or a good aspect. So that is second meaning given for Sat. Prayujyate is said both in common terms and in Vedam. Both in worldly terms as well as in Shastram, we see that Sat is explained as both existence as well as goodness of a particular entity. Tatha, in the same manner, prashaste karmani, even in worldly actions which are auspicious. In auspicious actions, auspicious activities, satchabdaha, the word sat yujyate is used. So even to indicate auspicious actions, the word sat is used. So for sat in this particular shlokam, Bhagavan is highlighting three different meanings. One is any entity which exists, that is known as sat. And then it indicates a good entity, a good aspect, that is also explained as sat. And then an auspicious action, any karma which is done in a good manner, that is also, that karma is also known as sat in this world. So these are the three different aspects explained in the word sat. Next is 27th shlokam. Here couple of more meanings are given for the word sat. Let us see that. Yajna tapasi dhane cha stiti saditi chochyate karma chaiva tadartiyam sadityeva va abhiviyate. Let's see the word by word meanings. Yajna, in yajna, tapasi, in tapasya, in penance, dhane cha, in dhanam, charities, stitihi cha, those traivarnikas, brahmanas, kshatriyas, vaishyas, we saw last time, to remain firm, sat iti uchyate, is said to be sat. Even the aspect of brahmanas, kshatriyas, vaishyas, remaining firm in their yajna, tapas and dhanam, that is also known as sat. So sat here means, this is the fourth meaning which is being shown by Bhagavan. Sat means being firm in their yajna, tapasya and dhanam. So that is also known as sat. And eva karma cha, tadartiyam eva karma cha, those rituals, actions which are meant for those traivarnikas. The rituals or activities which are done by traivarnikas, they are also known as sat. Sat iti eva, as sat only, abhidhiyate, said. So even those activities which are done by the brahmanas, kshatriyas and vaishyas according to Vedam, those are also known as sat. So totally five meanings for sat are explained by Bhagavan in these two shlokams. Now the final shlokam, concluding shlokam of this adhyayam, this chapter, let us see that. Ashradhaya hutam dattam tapastaptam kritam cha yat asadit yuchyate partha nachatat pretya no iha. So in this shlokam, Bhagavan explains the nature of unfaithful activities, engaging in yajnam, dhanam, tapas without the faith, and what is the result of that. So that is explained in this shlokam by Bhagavan. Let us see the word by word meanings. Partha, O son of Kunti, Ashradhaya kritam, performed without faith, yat, that, hutam, homa, yajna, sacrifice, dattam, danam, charity, yat tapaha, cha taptam, the penance which is performed, all of these, asat iti uchyate, are said to be as asat. So any action which is performed without faith. So for example, we perform a particular yajnam, but we don't have faith in that yajnam. We perform a particular dhanam, but we don't have faith. What is the purpose of the dhanam? What is the result of the dhanam? We don't have any faith in that. If we just do it, then those actions are also are known as asat here. Asat in the sense of they are not worthy, they are not going to lead to any good result. That is explained in the next part of the shlokam, the final part of the shlokam. Tat, that, pretyana, does not lead to moksham, liberation. So those unfaithful activities, they will neither lead to moksham, ihacha, no, does not lead to any materialistic benefit as well, nor they lead to any worldly benefits. Because yajnam, dhanam, tapas are done by worldly people with expecting some result. When it is done, when such act is done without any faith, the worldly result will also not come, and the moksham will also not come. The ultimate goal will also be not reached. So faithful execution of yagyam, danam, tapas, etc. are very much emphasized by Bhagavan in this particular chapter. So that is Shraddhatraya Vibhaga Yogam. We have seen that chapter now. With this we will conclude today's session. In the next session we will start with 18th chapter. Alvar Emperumanar Jiyar Thiruvadigale Sharanam, Jiyar Thiruvadigale Sharanam.
To learn such valuable information about our Sri Vaishnava Sampradaya, please download Koyil, K-O-Y-I-L app from Google Play Store or Apple App Store. Our website is koyil.org, K-O-Y-I-L.org.